Our faith as hip hop, as a hip hop nation, our faith on radio and TV is on house niggas' hands, because house niggas are running these platforms. You know what I'm saying? You give someone who doesn't understand your shit to make a decision on your shit. Lad God, I'm in salvation. I mean, I'm Rashid K. No blood clad boy, them done. No, why I say rude boy?
Do you expect me to come in after that?
Someone roll me a J, yeah?
I want to smoke.
You better say something.
What's up? What to say. How do you respond? Is that some baseline stuff?
That's not some, it's some patois. It's some patois.
Patois. Okay.
It's patois.
What's patois?
Patois, it's Jamaican English.
Oh, okay. Like Nigerian English would be Pidgin English.
Yes. It's actually their mother tongue. It's the first language in Jamaica. Mm. Actually, what you don't know is grade 11, I did my grade 11 in Canada.
Really?
As an exchange student. There was
this man.
Exchange student program. I did my grade 11 in Canada, and I was staying at the Caribbean community.
Okay.
Oh, so right. There was like a lot of Jamaicans, people from Barbados, Trinidad and Tobago.
Okay.
You know, the whole Caribbean. That's when.
How long were you there for?
For a year. I did my grade 11 there.
And then you were out.
Back to SA. You know, so that's where I learned my patois.
Patois.
Yeah.
Okay, shout out, man. There you have it.
Another masterclass from the Rashid.
Another masterclass.
One and only.
You don't know.
You're good, fam.
I'm awesome, bro.
Brand new week, brand new masterclass today. School is officially in session.
You know what time it is.
Hey, when you say things like that, I always wonder, like, what's on your mind? When you come in with some patois to open up the show, I have no idea what you're thinking.
Hey, man, I'm a scared of brain. My mind is everywhere.
That's how all rappers is.
Yeah.
Do you still rap, dog?
I still rap.
Someone said I should ask you if you're still like a rapper.
Yeah, I still rap, but it's not something I rap for the love, you know?
Yeah.
Because I'm still having fun with it. Like Master A said, as soon as I'm not having fun with it, I'm done with it.
Gotta quit it.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm not trying to rap to have a national tour, to have a whole marketing plan. I'm rapping for the fun of it.
Do you think, as a rapper, it's fair to critique other rappers?
As a rapper, is it fair to...
Critique other rappers. So I'm not a rapper. So yeah. I feel like it's fair for me to critique rappers because I'm coming as a fan, you know? I'm coming as a listener. I'm not coming as someone who can also do this thing. I can't. I just can hear what's really nice and what's not.
Well, it's part of the game, but... You need to open a door for you to be critiqued as well. You know what I'm saying?
So you take the crookeds with the straights. I get you.
That's why when you see soccer matches, they can bring a player to analyze the game.
Sure. Hey, sometimes hit me with these young punchlines.
It is what it is.
That day you said, if I call you a bitch ass nigga, does it mean I hate bitches? I was like, what?
What do you mean? Straight up and down. Like 6 o'clock.
Like 12 o'clock.
Yo, man.
On the clock.
Everybody's here today. We're about to get into one of the biggest and best classes that you need to plug into. If you're trying to get your hip-hop knowledge, if you're trying to get your music out here, we are the people to get your music on. Some people like to call us plugs. Some people call us gatekeepers.
Yeah, I know.
So, Rashid, are you a gatekeeper of hip-hop, South African hip-hop?
I'm not a gatekeeper.
Okay, wait, let me... Why I ask you is because you are, you know, Rashid, you've been in the hip-hop industry over 10 years.
Mm-hmm.
You are one of the heads of SA Hip Hop Awards, Back to the City, the biggest hip-hop event in the country.
Yes.
So you have access to letting any hip-hop, any artist who thinks they're dope, to get into the industry. You have the ability to do that. based on just those two things?
Of course, I do, to a certain extent.
To a certain extent, yeah. Okay. So the fact that you are one of the leaders in the industry in terms of running the biggest event in South African hip-hop, you still have boundaries to being someone who can put me on as an artist that is trying to get on.
Of course I can, but you have to be good. I'm not gonna put you on because you're my friend or you're my cousin or whatever.
Okay.
It has to be on merit.
I hear you, right? Yeah. You saying that, does that mean you are a gatekeeper?
I'm not a gatekeeper because I don't have the powers to block you. I don't have the powers to say, you can still make it without me.
That's deep, yeah. Okay. Yeah, that breaks it down, sort of, yeah?
Yeah.
What is a gatekeeper to you? Of any industry, not just hip-hop, like any industry has.
Any industry.
Because even house, amapiano, deep house, quieto, I'm sure, they are supposedly people that are gatekeepers. I once heard, right, that in the house industry, there's like, you know, your Freshers and your Euphonics and like just big names and your Black Coffees that are all part of a scheme. And they are supposedly the guys who get to call the shots in terms of how the house music industry works.
Probably.
I don't know if that's true.
I don't know if it's true as well. In that industry, it's probably true. But in hip in hip hop, nobody can control your destiny. Can say, I can have powers to put you on, but I cannot have the powers to block you, to say you'll never make it without me. You know, I've seen some situation where people say, if you leave this label, no radio station will ever play you again. You know,
yeah,
you're gonna be blacklisted in this industry. Those are gatekeepers. I don't have those.
You've heard that. You've heard that conversation.
Yes, I've heard that.
Who is having that conversation? You can tell me. I mean, it's just that stuff. Who is? Was it management? Was it other artists? Was it labels? Who was having that conversation?
It was label niggas. At some point, I was at Sony.
Okay.
Sony record label.
Mm.
There was a new group that was trying to release an album through that label, and then somebody in the industry that I know was like, no.
Not this guy.
Push that aside. Instead of this, reprint 10,000 copies of this group that was already out.
Okay,
you know,
okay.
That's gatekeeping.
We're getting somewhere here.
You know,
here,
that's
right?
Gatekeeping. If someone can affect your career and stop your career from moving forward, that's a gatekeeper.
Okay, would you not say, In the sense, and I'm bringing it back to you because I mean we can, and I'm sure it will bring it back to me, but if Back to the City is happening, Rashid can decide who is performing and who's not performing. Anish,
Rashid alone cannot decide. It's a team of 14 guys at Back to the City. Rashid can suggest that, you know what, I have this guy that I met called Big Zulu. I think he's dope.
Okay.
You guys should put him on. You know, that's one step in. Mm. If the guys agree that, okay, cool, this guy is actually not bad, we can give him a chance. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah.
But if they say, no, Rashid, your suggestion is not...
So there's a bit of a panel in Yana.
Yeah, there's a bit of
a panel. So how do you know that at Sony there's no panel that decides, you know? Because, I mean, it's a label. So they must be... I don't think there's like one guy who's like,
different,
no, not this
listen,
man.
Listen, different industries have different gatekeepers. Record labels have one A&R. Radio stations have one compiler.
Not necessarily.
Yeah, I know there's music teams.
Yes.
But
yes.
At the end
but
of the day...
But there's the main guy.
There's the main guy. You know? Even with soccer teams as well, there's a technical team, but there's one coach who will decide who's the first 11. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
So, here, with me and my team, there's no gatekeeper. Maybe we are gatekeeper as a collective. But there's no individual who's a gatekeeper.
I hear you. Okay, I get that.
When
I bring it on to me, I've heard the term a couple of times, and I can't agree that I am, like you're saying, fighting the same battle you're fighting.
Yeah.
In the sense that, yes, we are the plug.
Yes.
We are the plug. You bump into me, you give me your music. I have access to getting your music to the right people.
Yeah.
Whether you make it or not.
I can get you played on the radio.
Whether you make it or not, mm-hmm. is not up to me.
It's not.
So you can't say that there's gatekeepers in any industry, I feel.
I'm the gateway. I'm the opportunity to take you there. Whether you succeed there or not, it's not up to me.
It's up to?
The main guy.
No, dog.
The main.
It's not.
Yeah?
It's up to the person trying to get in. So if you're the artist, mm-hmm. yeah? And you send your music to OG,
mm-hmm.
right? And OG is telling you, look, the most I can do is send it to the compiler.
Yeah.
Right?
And that's the compiler is the main guy.
No, he's not. So the compiler can decide whether he's going to play this song or not. Mm-hmm. Let's say he decides to play it.
Mm-hmm.
Even if he plays it and it gets a million spins, it doesn't mean you're going to be the next big thing.
No.
The work comes from you.
The
from
music.
From you.
You see,
there's no gatekeepers.
You know what I said when Casper said, I'm leaving hip hop to Amapiano because hip hop has politics and there's too many gatekeepers. I was like, no, there are no gatekeepers in hip hop. You know, 90% of the radio compilers are house DJs. You know what I'm saying? You don't have hip hop niggas in high places making decisions over your career. You know, hip-hop niggas, as soon as they get to the other side, they forget about hip-hop. One of my favorite rappers, Proverb, he's dope as a rapper, but once he got to corporate, he was like, fuck hip-hop. He never did shit for hip-hop when he got to the other side of corporate.
Wasn't paying him like corporate was, though.
Yeah?
It wasn't paying like corporate was.
It's not about paying. It's not about paying. If I'm gonna get a radio job, I'm in a position to pitch, so to say, yo, how about we do this lot for hip hop? If I get a TV job, I can suggest, how about we do one mic for rappers, she's knees for rappers. I've done battle stations on YoTV. I've done She's Knees on ETV. I've done one mic on SABC One. Wherever I'm at, I make sure that I bring my culture in. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Proverb has had more opportunities and bigger platforms than me. I'm saying a lot of hip hop cats, when they get to the greener pastures, they forget about the culture. You know what I'm saying? And then we're going to complain that house niggas are blocking us, this and that. Because our own people, when they get there, they forget about us.
I hear you. And I feel like, from what you're saying, my dog,
yeah,
we're defending something that we shouldn't be defending.
I'm not defending anything. The gatekeepers are there.
There's
trust
no gatekeepers, bro.
There are gatekeepers.
There's no gatekeepers.
Someone who
there's
can say
nothing like that.
If there's someone who can say, no, I can't play this, or I can play this, that's a gatekeeper, you know. And we, our fate as hip hop, as a hip hop nation, our fate on radio and TV is on house niggas' hands, because house niggas are running these platforms. You know what I'm saying? You give someone who doesn't understand your shit to make a decision on your shit.
I hear you. I feel like you still have an old school way of looking at this whole situation.
What's the new school of way of
the
looking
school,
at it?
The new school, I call it the Justin Bieber movement, right?
Yeah.
It's 2021. It's the age of the internet right now, Joe. You do not need anybody for you to be dope and to be big. This podcast is an example of that. You can't tell me there's gatekeepers to podcasting because you can just do this whenever you want. Don't come. Let me finish it up.
Okay.
Even with the music, if your music is dope, my nigga, yes, in 1990s, Ban Ban, in 2005, 2014, it was tough to get your music played anywhere. But in today's time, anyone has access to your music, anyone has access to whatever it is you do. Is it art? Is it anything you do? Graphic? Zonke izinto ozenzayo nje.
Now.
But if you don't put in the work to get your shit out there, and if your shit is not dope, it's not going to move, dog.
Now.
There's no one who's going to play some shit
OG,
that's not fresh.
OG, let me give you a wake-up call. Right. South Africa is a third world country. Only 18% of the population have access to the internet. That 18% is not about the music. Some people on the internet are there for soccer. Some are there for politics. So music and entertainment is a small percentage. You know, you cannot discard. Radio is still the main platform, trust me. As much as we in Joburg and in Durban and in Cape Town, we think internet is the shit. It's not the shit yet. In the future, internet will be the biggest thing, but not right now. You know, only a few people, even in the urban areas, people are still struggling for data and shit. Only a few people have free Wi-Fi, access to Wi-Fi.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? We can make our situation and blow it out of proportion and think everyone lives like that. But that's not the case. 90% of South Africa is rural.
Is 90% of South Africa interested in hip-hop like that? Would we even know if that's what you're saying? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm saying, you're saying to me, if 90% of South Africa is rural, then hip-hop is not even a thing for someone who lives in the rural areas. Like, do they even...
Hip-hop is for some people who live in the rural, but not through the internet. I went on tour with Big Zulu.
Sure.
We were in the rural areas where people don't have access to internet, but they listen to Cozy FM, they listen to YFM, they listen to hip-hop shows. They have interest. They will play us their songs from their phones. They will rap their verses to us. You know what I'm saying? But they don't have data and Wi-Fi to watch this podcast.
That's what I'm saying. Forget about them watching it. How hard is it for someone who loves hip-hop in the rural area to even get their music anywhere? Forget about online. Even to a radio station. It's probably harder for them to get
to
an internet cafe.
It's almost impossible.
And load... You can in the rural areas, though.
Yeah, you can.
In the rural areas, as much as it's rural, there's a smartphone somewhere in and around those areas. Somebody has a smartphone. If you really want to do this hip-hop thing, you will fucking
OG,
make it happen,
OG,
dog.
It's not about the resources. It's about the know-how.
You can do it, man.
It's about
you
the know-how.
I think we're underestimating South Africa's intelligence with that
look,
kind of shit.
Your mom or your grandmom probably has a smartphone, but they only use SMSs and phone calls.
You're talking about my grandmother.
No, I'm saying it's the point is it's not about the resources, it's about the know-how. If you know how to use that, then you can get there. You can have the internet cafe, but if you don't know how to use it, it's the know-how, it's the knowledge.
My G, as the rural areas, there's DSTV in somewhere in the rural areas.
Yes.
Yes. Right?
Yes.
So if there's DSTV, already that creates some sort of intelligence or knowledge around the world and how the world works. If you just have DSTV. So if you're getting to an internet cafe or you know you have access to a phone, you are able, if you have access to DSTV,
you are able
to get onto an email address and send your music to
the main thing or put it on YouTube. The main thing is... If you're using your DSTV for Isibaya and SuperSport, you're not gonna learn. It's not about the resources, it's how the knowledge, how you use that thing. You can have DSTV
and watch Isibaya. I get that.
And Uzalo and whatever.
I get that. I'm saying to you, if you're interested in hip hop and you're a hip hop cat and you're young and you're trying to do this thing, you should have the know-how.
Yeah.
You should have the know-how to put your music out there. If you really
want... Yeah, you can...
That's why I say to you, there's no gatekeepers because the power is in self. The power is in you. You can do whatever the fuck you want to do.
Yeah.
Whether Rashid is there, whether OG is there, whether there's all the radio stations you love and know, you can get your music out there. Whether you live in the rurals or you live in the suburbs.
Only if
there's
you have
no
the
more
know-how.
Excuses. There's no more excuses, Sheed.
Only if you have the know-how.
All right, I don't know.
How? Tell me one rapper from the rural areas that has blown up.
Big Zulu.
Big Zulu is from the Vaal.
What?
Big Zulu is from Orange Farm. Big Zulu is from Orange Farm, Palm Springs.
What?
Talk to me, man.
Lie.
Big Zulu came to Joburg in high school. Nigga, listen to me.
What?
Big Zulu came to Joburg in high school. Big Zulu came from Bergville to Palm Springs in the Vaal in high school.
So
Big Zulu even went to a multiracial. Big Zulu, as much as you, he speaks that Zulu. Big Zulu went to a Model C school. You know, nigga,
are you exposing Big Zulu?
I'm not exposing him. It's the truth. No, he said it.
Hey,
listen.
You're fucking up Big Zulu's image to me right
now. No, listen. He said it on Mac G's podcast, on his own interview.
Mm.
He used to stay in Berea, Hillbro, and he used to go to school in Auckland Park, Sophia Town, that side. You know what I'm saying? Big Zulu has been here since high school. Originally, he's from KZN, Bergville. You know, he started, when he came here, he didn't know nothing about hip-hop. He learned about hip-hop in Joburg. He started his hip-hop in Joburg. He decided to represent KZN.
Sjava?
Sjava is the one
who... Come on now, let's end this conversation. Let's move on.
No, Sjava is also from Bergville. They're from the same village as Big Zulu.
But now you're saying...
Sjava came late in Joburg. But I'm telling you that Big Zulu came here while he was still in high school.
I get that. Sure now we're talking about rural rappers. People from the rurals who actually became rappers. I gave you two Nyana examples.
Sjava.
You can do this thing, Sheed.
No, I used to hang out with these niggas before they were, before you knew them.
Don't make it personal.
No, but listen. Sjava was here in Joburg CBD. You know, was staying here in Joburg. He was messing with Raf and MT and them. They were all in the CBD. You know, before Ambitious. So Sjava got signed and blew up in Joburg, not straight from the rural areas. That's what I'm saying. I was asking you, name one nigga that blew up from the rural.
I'll find one. Y'all help me out.
Hit me up in the comments. Show me there must be, there's definitely, I'm sure Zulu Boy is somewhere in Makassar.
Zulu Boy was discovered in Durban at Bed Center by Sipos Tole.
Mara wagupi.
Wase Wamashu in Durban, Township Nduzum.
Ekas. Nah, I guess that's not as rural as...
You know...
Chance, help me here. Rural?
None.
Nah, there is one.
I funny...
Comment section. We need to move on.
I funny had to come to Joburg. Proverb had to come from Kimberley to Joburg.
But they made a hustle to come here. They found a know-how.
Yes, you are saying you can make it from the rural through the internet. I'm saying name one.
I'm saying you can find a way to make it.
Yeah, you can.
And you should, if you really want to do it.
You can, but you haven't. I'm saying name one.
There isn't. But nah, Lindo's not a hip hop.
Yeah, I'm saying.
We digress.
The reality is internet. Internet is still a small fraction. We need to do the groundwork. We need to go out there. We need to be on the street. We need to go out and hustle. You'll never get signed from your bedroom.
True.
Yeah.
And with
gatekeepers. Let's get back to the point. Nigga.
No, we need to move on from the point.
We're not done yet. So what's your conclusion? Do we have gatekeepers or not?
No gatekeepers.
I'm still saying there's no gatekeepers. Kids, listen to Rashid.
Don't listen to Rashid.
Kids,
do your thing. Work, dog.
You still
work.
There are people who still have to pay payola to get played. There are people who still take bribes.
Yeah, they are. Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Everything is not black and white. You know what I'm saying? So it's not that easy. Get out of your bedroom, get out of your internet, come to the real world.
Free period, please.
Who who we got? Who we got?
Sheesh. I even forgot. Let me check out my notes real quick, dog. Damn.
We got V-Touch, man. What you talking about? You the one for my heart. Girl, you were a blessing that I waited for. And that's just how we started. For my heart, girl, you were a blessing that I waited for. Steady on the balcony, we take a view. Girl, I wonder where were you so I could be with you. Like a superhero, baby, here to rescue you. Got my arms around your body, stuck like super glue. Ooh.
V-Pin today, young homie, 20 years old.
From Moms.
From Moms, Mami Lodi. I've never actually been to Moms, dog. Isn't
that sad? They looted the radio station there. Moms FM.
Yo,
motherfuckers.
And they shouldn't be fucking up shit that we fuck with, right?
Yo.
Not at all, bro.
Aye, bro.
I'm actually just looking for the exact location where we can find V-Touch. But V-Touch is a very, I hate to use this word, but it's true. Mm. He's eclectic. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So he raps.
Mm-hmm.
His beats on point. Mm-hmm. He produces his own music as well.
Yeah.
And he's only 20 years old, man.
Yo, he's too dope, man. You see, he's on that...
I want to find something for you to show you.
He's on that trap soul. He sings beautifully, man.
On a different vibe, dog.
Yeah.
On a different tip.
And still, he sings, but you can feel the hip-hop element. You can feel this kid is hip-hop.
Yep. Just like original, no music video, because that's something I've actually realized, that a lot of up-and-coming artists have good music, but they don't have videos, man. And in today's time,
that's why we're putting them on. Like, you don't have to have a music video. Word. If you have a music video, it means you're a cheese boy.
Ah, come on. You can't say that.
Yeah.
You have a music, you can, like, you can shoot. Back to the conversation we just had. If you want a music video, you can have a music video.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, a song is enough for us to put you on.
True. Just a song, just like this homie V-Touch, he comes from Mami Lodi. Very lyrical, the homie. Hasn't signed with anyone yet.
Yeah.
But I do know that there's a lot of people knocking on his door at the moment. So I thought it would be dope for us to profile him today. Check out his music, go out and download his stuff. Support some local. He's 20 years old, Rishi.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Maybe we should open up Masterclass Records.
I don't know if we're gonna. Hey, you and I. But we'd have some dope artists, right?
Yeah, yo, we'd kill it. We'd kill it.
Yeah, we're signing V-Touch. So if you want to hear some of his stuff, it's all over Spotify, YouTube. That's my free period for the day.
And that's my cosign.
Yes. Cosigns. That's the... Bundy, write down cosign. We're going to talk about cosigning.
Yeah.
Who you got?
Up next, we have Cash Clothing.
Hey.
Profiling them niggas.
Hey.
Yeah. They've been dressing us, you know, since day one. Cash Clothing, you know what I'm saying? But yo, them niggas have like dope merchandise. Check them out on Facebook.
Yeah.
Cash_clothing. Check them out on Instagram, Cash Clothing. They got some dope hip hop stuff. And check this video.
So shout out to the homies, man. As you can see, proudly South African, yo. That's what we do out here. That's what the free period is for. So shout out to Cash Clothing. The one thing I'm really crazy about with the homies is the colorways of all the different stuff that you can get, man.
Yeah.
I rocked this one last episode. Got some different colorway today. Tomorrow, ganyiwa. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah. I've been rocking Cash Clothing ever since we started.
Do we have details? The details will pull up, how you can get a hold of them, the social medias.
Yeah.
DM if you want some nice stuff, man. Good prices as well. Decent, really good material. Fresh. It's not a one wash vibe. This
Some never.
Good qualities. Even this thing here, can you see and feel the shit?
No, I got my own.
No homo.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, before we go, what's the review for this episode?
Hey, reactions for today.
LeMain just dropped.
Oh, wee.
Mermaids and Other Stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, man, let's go with the history of Gigi LeMain, where you know her from. I'll tell you where I know her from.
I've known Gigi LeMain since like grade 10. When she was in grade 10, I became her first manager, and I managed Gigi LeMain. We've been working together from day one. You know what I'm saying?
You sound like a proud dad right now. And now she's getting married.
You know what I'm saying? Back and forth. You know what I'm saying? Back and forth, ups and downs.
Ups and downs.
You know, I'm proud of her.
Yo.
She's one of the underrated speeders in the game. You know what I'm saying?
I wouldn't say she's underrated. I wouldn't call Gigi underrated. But I think people do rate Gigi. I mean, she's top three in terms of MCs, female MCs, which I hate to say, but top three. And in a lot of people's books.
No, I agree.
I do agree, because obviously you've known her since grade 10.
Yes, I agree. But I'm thinking, yo, female rappers have a lot to deal with, you know?
Yeah.
Especially female artists in general, not just rappers. Especially colorism, you have to be light skinned, you have to be beautified.
Facts.
So there's a lot of pressures with women.
Yeah.
That's why you see some of them ended up bleaching their skin and showing their booty and doing all that crazy stuff that has nothing to do with the art. Because the society expects more than music from them.
True, man.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna speed it up. Yeah. Because I know you have a large history with her. Shout out to Gigi, man. I've always rated her myself. But this project right here, Mermaids and Other Stuff, is her best work.
I agree.
That is her best work, man. I've never been able to sit through a Gigi album.
Yeah.
I think I only skipped one song. I forgot the name of the song. I actually wanted to talk about it when I was skipping it. But other than that, man, I can listen to the whole thing. I think on this album, she basically showed us everything she can do.
Yeah.
She rapped. She sang.
She sang.
Melodies.
Bars. And she sang well on Fire.
Whoever. Oh, man. Fire's the best song on the album.
Yeah, Fire.
Fire's the best song on the
whoever
album. That's the radio joint, right? Yeah. That should be the radio
whoever
joint.
Whoever engineered, recorded, engineered Fire got Gigi right.
Hey, all the female features on that album as well, man. The Femcees, Shoma Josie's. Oh, that verse was insane, dog. And I don't rate Shoma Josie as a rapper.
Sosobala.
I don't know what the name of the song
is,
Marayo.
Sosobala. Shoma Josie came through. And I like what Gigi did. She brought all the female rappers together. She has Nadia.
She has
Shoma Josie, Muzli.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's like the sisterhood.
That's why I think she called the album Mermaids and Other Stuff.
Yeah.
Because I think it was her bringing together all the girls to come do what we do best and rap.
Yeah.
And then there's the other stuff.
Because they're always being pitted together.
Yeah, there's a joint there with PH, Raw X.
Yeah.
Dope joints as well.
Yeah.
The other stuff is that. And then there's a weird song that she has. There's a piano song on there as well. Or it's a song, it's a mix. There's the one
with Scooby Nero.
There's a lock drum.
There's some Afro with Scooby Nero.
Lock drum,
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, so for me, best work, man, from Gigi, dog.
I know.
Shout out Gigi. How much are you rating it? We need to rate it so we can get out of here. It's getting dark.
Yeah, it's 8 out of 10 from me.
8? Why are you not giving it a 10?
Because I think there's one or two skippable tracks.
Okay.
Hey.
Sometimes you say some shit.
I always say some shit, not sometimes.
I was trying to corner you.
Not sometimes.
Because you know you've known her since grade 10.
Yeah.
So generally, you can't really say anything bad about Gigi. I feel like Gigi went through a time when she was struggling.
Mm-hmm.
The music wasn't dope. It was just singles here and there. But what she's given us now, man, you need to sit down and listen to that album. You don't even have to sit down. It's one of those you can play at a kickback with the homies, chilling. It's just, you just hear this chick just doing her thing. You know what I mean?
I think she found herself.
I also think so, bro.
Yeah.
I hope, even with the visuals now,
it
works the same. Like, I hope she can find herself.
Mm.
Because I know she struggled with that as well. You know, there was a time when Ambitious wanted her to look a certain way, and then she wanted to look a certain way.
And there's that track with Blackie as well, her single, her current single.
Which one is this one?
It's Filling You with Blackie and Mikasa.
Ah, no, I didn't like that one.
You don't like that one?
Nah, didn't like
it. I think that's a radio-friendly track.
Really? I think the radios are playing that one, though.
Yeah, they are playing it.
So shout out to Gigi getting an 8. We've got to wrap it up. 2 minutes. 8 out of 10. I'm going to give it... Because I say it's her best work, I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10. It's really good. It's really, really
good.
I'm very impressed.
Shout out.
Outside of Blackie's album, this is another South African album that I can listen to fully.
Yeah.
I love Orquesta Benu.
We have 2 albums in 2021. Gigi and Blackie and...
Nothing else. All y'all shit is trash.
Subscribe and comment. We out.